you all to my channel. If this is your first time of coming to my channel, thanks a lot. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share and subscribe. Join us on Facebook, teegdesigns, and also on Instagram. I'm going to put down the details in the description box below. Visit our website, and also you can join us for training, both online training and physical training. So in today's video, I'm going to be making a simple video on how to cut Caribbean gown. If you want me to make a video on how to cut Caribbean skirts, kindly comment below and don't forget to like this video, and I'm going to make a video on how to cut Caribbean skirts. But for today's video, we're going to be cutting Caribbean gown. Now, yeah, I have a simple illustration on what a Caribbean gown looks like. This is what we have for our basic gown, and from this part down, we have like layers, right? So note that you have to determine how many layers you want your Caribbean to have. So basically, I'm going to have 3 layers. You can go ahead and make yours 4 layers, 5 layers. It depends on what you want. But for me, 3 to 4 layers is actually fine. So I'm going to make use of 3 layers for the lower part of our Caribbean. Now, what are the basic measurements required? Of course, you need your basic measurements. But when you want to cut, there are basic measurements you are going to calculate, right? So our shoulder to our half length, this is where we have half length, we have 18 inches. Shoulder to half length, and our half length is basically 1 inch above our navel, we have 18 inches. Now, from your waistline to your gown length, we have 45 inches. Waistline to your gown length, you have 45 inches. Now, what you are going to do now is you are going to go ahead and divide your 45 inches into how many inches, how many layers you want your Caribbean gown to be, right? So we have 45 inches. Now, 45 inches, I'm going to go ahead and add 2 inches. Why am I adding 2 inches? For every layer, you have to add additional 2 inches. Now, the reason why you are going to add 2 inches is we are going to use 1 inch to join it. You are going to use 1 inch of the second layer to attach it to the first layer, and you use 1 inch to tape the lower part. So we have 47 inches, right? We have 47 inches. Now, it simply means that from our waist, our shoulder to our hip, shoulder to waist, where we have our half length, we have 18 inches, and from the waist to our gown length, we have 45 inches. So we added 2 inches to it, we have 47 inches. Now, you are going to go ahead and divide your 47 into 3. Why are we dividing it into 3? It's because the layers of our Caribbean are 3 layers. If you want your Caribbean to be 4 layers, you go ahead and divide what you have from your waist to your gown length into 4. If you want it to be 5 layers, you go ahead and divide it into 5. But like I said, I'm going to be making the one of 3 layers. So I'll go ahead and divide it into 3. Now we have 47 divided by 3. We have 15.6. We have 15.6. Now, we have 15.6 for each layers, right? For the first layer, where we have 15.6, like I said, I'm going to add 2 inches to each layer. So this 15.6 plus 2 inches, we are going to have 17.6. So it simply means that for the first layer, we'll have 17.6. For the second layer, we have 17.6. But for the third layer, we are going to go ahead and add an extra 2 inches. Why are we adding an extra 2 inches to the third layer? Because of our sewing allowance. Because the last layer is where we are going to have our sewing allowance, and that is where we are going to aim at the lower part of our gown. So if the first layer is 17.6, this second layer will be 17.6. This third layer, we are going to add 2 inches because we are going to end this lower part. So once you add your 2 inches to it, you are going to have 19.6. So 2 inches here is what we are going to use to end, and the 2 inches we added for each layer, we are going to use it to place each other on it, right? You're going to understand that when we are cutting. So this is what we have. Now for our half length, we have 18 inches. We go ahead and add 1 inch for our sewing allowance. We are going to have 19 inches. So for our shoulder to waist, we have 19 inches. For every of the layer, the first layer we're going to cut 17.6, the second layer 17.6, and the third layer we have 19.6. Now another question is, how are you going to determine how many inches of fabric is required for each layer? How are you going to determine how many inches is required for each layer? Now what you are going to do is that you are going to make use of your hip measurement. Our hip measurement is 36, so we have our hip measurement to be 36. So you go ahead and multiply your hip measurement by 3 or by 2.5. Now, if you don't want your Caribbean to be too bogus, like if you don't want your Caribbean to be too full or too big, go ahead and multiply your hip by 2.5, right? But if you want to have a very full Caribbean, go ahead and multiply your hip measurements by 3. So my hip measurement is 36. I will go ahead and multiply it by 3. I'm going to have so when I went ahead to multiply my hip measurement by 3, I'm going to have 108 inches. So for every layer, for the length of every layer, I'm going to be cutting out 108 inches, and for the length of it, you are going to make use of this 17.6, 17.6, and 19.6. But for the measurements required, the amount of fabric required for each layer, we are going to make use of 108. Now, some of you tape measure might not have that, but guess what, guys? We have tape measure that is beyond 60 inches. So when you want to cut dresses like Caribbean gown, you are going to make use of that tape measure, and the tape measure is available at our store. Okay, I'm going to put down the details below if you want to get a tape measure which is beyond 160 inches, like your regular 60 inches. So note that if you don't want your Caribbean to be too full, go ahead and multiply your hip by 2.5. And also, in order for you to know how many inches you are supposed to multiply it by, try to consider the measurement of the person you are working with and also the amount of fabric. So the amount of fabric and the measurements you are working with will determine if you are to multiply the hip by 2.5 or you have to multiply the hip by 3 inches. So this is just like the basic calculation of how to get your Caribbean. So now let's move to our normal measurement where we are going to calculate it. At the basic measurements required, our shoulder measurements, bust measurements, waist, hip, and our gown length and the half length. So our shoulder measurements is 14 divided by 2, we have 7, plus 1 inch we have 8. Our bust is 36 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 10.5. Our waist is 32. 32 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 10. Our hip is 36. 36 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 10.5. And note that you are also to multiply this your hip by either 2.5 or by 3 inches, which I explained earlier. Now, our gown length is 63. We have 63 minus our half length, which is 18. We have 45 inches. Now, this 45 inches plus 2 inches for our sewing allowance, we have 47 inches. For our half length, we have 18 inches plus 1 inch for our sewing allowance, we have 19 inches. So these are the basic measurements required. And with me here, I have my pattern paper. Pattern papers are available in white and also in brown. One thing about this brown pattern paper is it's about 60 inches long and it comes in a bundle. And we also have the white pattern paper. So now, if you want me to make a video on how to cut Caribbean skirts, don't forget to comment below and give this video a thumbs up, and I'm going to make a video. The first thing we are going to do now is to draft the upper bodice for our Caribbean gown. So we are going to go ahead and mark our basic measurement. Shoulder to armhole 9.5. Shoulder to bust 10. Under bust 13.5. Shoulder to our waist 18 inches. Go ahead and mark. After marking our lines, the next thing we are going to do now is to go ahead and mark our dart measurement, which is 4 inches. On our waistline, we'll mark 4 inches for our dart. We'll go ahead and connect the lines together. On the waistline, we'll mark 1/2 inch on both sides. We'll go ahead and connect it together. So this is what we have. So I'll go ahead and cut this point where our upper bodice ends. With that, we'll go ahead and extend this dart line to our shoulder. On the shoulder line, we'll go ahead and mark 5 inches. We'll connect this shoulder line to the bust line. This is what we are going to have. We'll go ahead and close our shoulder dart. Once you close it, you take your basic measurement, which is our shoulder measurement is 7 inches. Our bust is 10.5 and our waist is 10 inches. We'll go ahead and connect the lines together. Make use of your armhole curve. Connect your bust line to your shoulder line. So this is what we are going to have for the front block, okay? So I'll go ahead and cut. Now, once you are done with that, the next thing you have to do now is to come to your under bust line and mark 1/2 inch on both sides. On your under bust line, mark 1/2 inch on both sides. Then you go ahead and connect the lines together. This is what we are going to have for our bustier effect. So I'll go ahead and cut this out. So this is what we are going to have. So we go ahead and mark our neckline. For the wideness of the neckline, I'm going to make use of 4 inches. And for the deepness of our neckline, I'm going to make use of 6 inches. I will go ahead and connect it together. So once I connect it, I will go ahead and cut out the neckline. So for the front block, this is what we are going to have. First block, we'll go ahead and mark 2 inches for our zip allowance. Mark 2 inches. Once we are done with that, we'll connect the lines together. Now, this is what we are going to have. We'll go ahead and mark our dart measurement, which is 4 inches. Connect the lines together. On the waistline, mark 1/2 inch on both sides. So this is what we are going to have. So you go ahead and take your shoulder measurement, which is 7 inches, our bust measurement, which is 10.5, and our waist measurement, which is 10 inches. I will go ahead and connect the lines together. Now for the wideness of our neckline, I'm going to make it of 4 inches, and for the deepness, I'm going to make it of 3 inches. Go ahead and connect the lines. I will also mark 1 inch for my shoulder slope. So this is what our back block is going to look like. So I'll go ahead and cut this out. This is what we are going to have for the back block, and for the front block we are going to have 2 pieces. So we'll go ahead and set this aside. For us to get the first step, we are going to mark 17.6. That is for the first layer. So we go ahead and mark that. So this is what we have. Now for the length. Now for the width, that is the amount of inches we are going to gather, we said it is our hip, which is 36 multiplied by 3, we have 108. So we go ahead and measure 108 by this side, and for the length we have 17. For the length this way we have 17.6, and for the width we've gone ahead to cut out 108 inches, and I'm making use of this tape measure, which is more than 60 inches. So it is very easy for you to achieve that, especially when you are making use of tape measures that are more than 60 inches and they are available at our store. So this is for the first layer. We'll go ahead and set that aside. So for the second layer, we'll also be needing about 108 inches for the breadth, and for the length we will need 17.6 inches. So I've gone ahead to cut out my 17.6 by 108. For the third layer, we've gone ahead to cut out 19.6 inches for the length, and also for the breadth we are also going to maintain our 108 inches. So this is for the third layer. We'll go ahead and set this aside. The upper block, it is actually very good for you to cut your layers first before you cut out your basic block, right? So for the upper block, I've gone ahead to fold my fabric into 2, and I'll place my back block on it, and I'll go ahead and cut this out. After cutting it out, this is what we have. We have 2 pieces for the back block. We'll go ahead and set this aside. I've gone ahead to fold my fabric into 2, and I placed my front block on it. I will go ahead and cut this out. After cutting it out, this is what we have. We have 2 pieces for the side, and we have our middle block. Go ahead and set this aside. Do now is I'm going to go ahead with my wording, which has a shining part and a smooth part. I'm going to attach the shining part to the fabric, and I will give it a very hot press. So place each wording on the sides of our bust here, and we are going to go ahead and stitch it together. So we go ahead and stitch it together to give us a single piece. So once we are done with that, we have a single piece for the front block, and also for our lining we also have a single piece. Go ahead and sew your neckline, your armhole, and the sides, and we are going to use the lining to turn it up. For the back block, we have 2 pieces, and we've turned it with our lining, and we've gone ahead to fixing our dart for the back block. Once you are done with that, place your front block on your back block. Go ahead and stitch your shoulders together. After that, use your bust measurement and your waist measurement to stitch the sides together to give us a single
piece.
Another way to achieve your gathers is by loosening your machine stitch, then you stitch it all the way down. What you are going to do now is you are going to take a thread, pull it this way. I hope you guys can see it. Then you keep pulling. So it pulls. You just keep pulling it this way. So you can see the fabric have moved. So you have to be very careful while you are doing this, because once the thread cuts, you have no option than to start again. So what I do is that I usually run my stitch into two, like in two places. So if the first one cuts, I can just continue pulling the second one, right? So this is a long process, and you are going to go ahead and do this for the three steps of your Caribbean gown. And if you want yours to be four steps, you go ahead and keep gathering this too, so you can see it moves. So that is that about gathers. Now once I'm done gathering all of them, now while you are gathering it, like I said, you have to be careful so that your thread doesn't cut, and try to run the stitch in two places, so just in case the first one cuts, you can use the other one. Just imagine when you're almost done and then the thread just cuts. That can be so painful, guys. It can be so painful, trust me. So while I'm doing this, I'm going to go ahead and do this for the three layers, and I will stitch them on each other. Like, I'm going to sew them on each other, and you will discover that while I'm running my stitch, I hope it's focused now, I left about half inch. I didn't run it at this tip, right? I didn't run it at this tip, but rather this is where we have our gathers going on. So it simply means that I left about half inch from the tip to this part, so that while you gather this part up, here can just come out. So don't gather at the tip while you are sewing. Come down with half inch or 1 inch. It depends on how you want this upper part to be. And another thing I went ahead to do is that I went ahead to weave this layer. Let me show you guys. I went ahead to lock the upper part, because this upper part is going to be showing outside. So it's neater when you just kind of lock it, that is, you weave it, okay? And don't forget that your stitch should start by half inch. So this is where my stitch started from. So that is that about it. And you are only going to gather the upper part of each layer, right? You're only going to gather the upper part of this layer. So if you find this video very educative, please give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. Drop your questions or any topic you want us to treat, okay? And follow us on our Facebook page, teegdesigns, and also visit our website, okay? We have beautiful illustration over there. So I hope you guys can see how it's coming out already. So you can see this upper part, that is the half inch where we left. You can see how we just gathered so beautifully. This is what it looks like. I don't know if you guys can see it, but this is what it looks like, right? So I'll go ahead and do that for the three layers. This is where we gathered. While you are gathering it, make sure it's equal to your waist measurements, right? Make sure it's equal to your waist measurements. Now, for the second layer, we have, once you gather it up, this is the second layer, you also gather it up, right? Now, you gather the upper part where we weaved. You are going to go ahead and stitch this upper part. Now, on this is our first layer. This is our first layer and this is the second layer. We've gone ahead to gather them up. Now, this upper part of your second layer, while you are gathering it up, so you will go ahead and stitch it this way. You will go ahead and stitch it this way. Don't forget that you've gathered it up already. So you just go ahead and stitch it this way. So you can see the first layer. You can see how the second, have the second layer this way. Now for the third layer also, you will go ahead and gather it up also for the third layer. After gathering it up, you will also go ahead and stitch it. So for the third layer also, you go ahead and gather it up. After that, you will also go ahead and stitch it. This is the second layer, so you come up with about 1 inch and then you stitch the upper part where you've gathered to the third layer. So at the end of the day, you are going to have like your three layers sewn together. This is the third layer, the second layer, and the first layer. Stitching it up, we have our complete three pieces. And for the upper block, this is our upper block where we've gone ahead to have a single piece. We are going to go ahead and, now mind you, while you are stitching, you are sewing on the front, okay? You are placing it this way and you are stitching it on the front, right? So this is our upper block. Now, like I said earlier, the first layer is going to be equal to what you have on your waistline. So you go ahead and place your first layer this way. You go ahead and place your first layer this way and then you stitch it to your basic block. So your first layer gather will be equal to your waistline and then you stitch it this way. So this is what we are going to have. You have your basic block, you have your first layer attached this way, gathered up. You have the second layer and you also have your third layer. So once you are done with that, you go ahead and fix in your zip. Right, go ahead and fix in your zip so that you can lock this up at the back. After fixing our zip, I'll show you guys what it looks like.
So this is what our Caribbean gown looks like. So you can see the layers of our Caribbean gown. We have the first layer, so you can see how long it is. So we have the first layer, the second layer, the third layer of our Caribbean gown. You can go ahead and make yours two layers or four layers, and we have our basic bodies. So thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe.